Hello, good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and our guest this morning is Matthew Coulson, joining us to talk about your results this week from MP Evans, because you've upped your dividend by 25%, and this is due to soaring palm oil prices, sending your profits up by 53% in the first 6 months of 2022. So a very good morning to you, Matthew.
Good morning, Katie.
So tell me more about your results that were published this week. Take us through some of those highlights, if you would.
Yes, of course. So we're very happy to be publishing our results for the first half of 2022 this week. It's been a very interesting period for the group. We continue with our strategic development. We saw crops continue to increase. So group crops and crops from our associated scheme, smallholder areas, were up by 4% in the period. And as you've highlighted, we saw a significant increase in pricing in the first half of this year. We were able to achieve an average mill gate price for our CPO, our crude palm oil production, of over $1,000 per tonne in the first half of this year.
And there's a lot going on in the background here, because prices of all oil commodities have jumped due to the war in Ukraine. Palm oil, though, was exacerbated by a ban on exports in Indonesia as well. So maybe tell us a bit more about the background, if you would.
Yes, you're right to highlight that. So we saw in the first half of this year a significant jump in CPO, crude palm oil pricing, around the start of March, which obviously was connected to the outbreak of war in Ukraine. Prices for CPO, CIF Rotterdam, jumps to almost $2,000 a tonne at the start of March, really unprecedented levels. Now, they've moderated a little bit since then, but the average across all of the first half of the year was over $1,600 per tonne. Now, somewhat inevitably, when prices are quite this high, there was activity from the Indonesian government to think about how they wanted to update the tax and levy regime applied to CPO. Slightly surprisingly, towards the end of April and into early May, there was an export ban applied by the Indonesian government. That only lasted for 3 to 4 weeks, but that did have something of a significant effect, particularly when you think that Indonesia actually produces something like 60% of the world's palm oil. It's a big consumer of palm oil as well, but it only consumes something like 20% of the world's palm oil. So when you think about that difference, even a short-term ban can have a significant effect on the market.
And explain to me why you endured a production ease.
Yes, of course. So one of the main factors behind that slight easing in production was a response we deliberately made during the period of that export ban. We essentially have three sources of crop that we use to fill up our production capacity. Crop that comes from our own areas that we harvest, crop that comes from scheme smallholder areas that are associated with our estates that we also manage and harvest. But then a third source of crop, which comes from independent suppliers that we bring in to fill up spare capacity in our mills. We took a decision whilst the ban was in place just to reduce the amount of crop that we bring in from outside, just to manage the amount of storage capacity that we have associated with our mills. And because we took that decision, there was, as you say, a very small reduction in our total production in the first half of the year. It is important, though, just to say that we are now back into a position of bringing in just the same amount of outside crop as we did before the ban.
And how does a company like yours plan? Because presumably and hopefully we're not expecting the war in Ukraine to continue forever. So how does that leave you in regards to what you plan for tomorrow or a year or two? You know, where do you see the company going?
Well, for us, of course, we inevitably are price takers. We don't control the price that we receive for the oil that we produce. So we focus very much on being in control as much as we can be of the quantity of production and continuing to increase the amount of production that we have available, being in control as much as we can be on the cost of that production. And then when it comes to prices, as it happens, as you can see, we've been in an extremely high price environment in the first half of the year. And whilst prices have moderated to a degree in the second half, they continued to be, you know, by historic terms, still very high prices, but clearly, you know, we can't ultimately influence the price that we receive for our products.
Mm. And how would you conclude your latest performance and just how the performance of the company has done so in the last year or so?
Well, I mean, we've been in record results over the last 12 months. If you look at the second half of 2021 and into the first half of 2022, we've achieved record results. A lot of that inevitably is down to price, but we continue on our upward trajectory when it comes to our increasing production. And we expect that upward trajectory to continue when it comes to the increasing yield from our existing estates and our existing production facilities. And we're continuing to increase our production facilities. We have another mill, the group's sixth mill, coming on stream at the end of this year.
Okay, your sixth mill. We'll look forward to catching up when that's up and running. Pleasure to have you on this morning. Thank you, Matthew, from MP Evans here on Proactive London.
Thank you very much.